one of the largest problems in yacht brokering, in my experience, is that when we go into a survey of a boat, there's a couple things we don't know. One is that we don't know how the seller is going to behave when the survey is finished and the buyer says, this is not working and that's not working and I don't like this and I don't like that and therefore I'm going to only give you this. And we don't know how the buyer is going to behave to the seller. Okay? And so setting people's expectations before they go into a survey is really important, in my experience. And trying to, like if you were a seller and you accepted a contract on your boat and you said, look, this is rock bottom for me. I'm giving you a great deal on this boat and you may be in fact doing it. But then you get a buyer that comes down and thinks that the survey is another opportunity for him to lower the price another $15,000 or $20,000, the chances are it's never gonna work. Because if you have a gap in perception between a buyer and a seller on the value of the boat after the survey, and one party thinks that the boat's worth a lot less, and the other says, I'm selling it to you for cheap as chips, buddy, then you're going to go all the way down to St. Martin or Tortola or whatever, and you're going to pay for a costly survey, and you've gone through a whole lot of work, and you're not going to have a deal. What I see happen a lot is that deals fall apart, and when they do, oftentimes, and I'm in a position as a broker, I see buyers accept the wrong boats all the time and reject the wrong boats all the time. I see it a lot. And the reason they reject boats is that they don't have a clear grasp of the value of that boat in the condition that it's in, because their expectations for that boat at that price exceed the market reality. Okay? I see this a lot. And of course, remember, the older the boats get, the more the survey is going to come back with lots of stuff. Well, come back to Lagoon 440. We have one under survey today. I couldn't attend, so I hired somebody to do it, and I just called the surveyor, and the engine alarm is going off on one of the sail drive legs, indicating that the sail drive seals are leaking, okay? A very common incident, by the way. And so the surveyor alerted me, and I said, okay, well, when the boat gets lifted out of the water, we need to block it, and we need to go ahead and have those sail drive seals changed out. Whether the buyer accepts the boat or not, I'm going to tell the seller, you don't want to have leaky sail drive seals, and since the buyer is having to pay to haul the boat out of the water, you should go ahead and fix it, okay? That's just it. Every survey is going to come back with a range of things. And if I could give you any piece of advice, whether you're working with me or somebody else, is pick the big fights. Never pick the small fights. Okay? Because the surveyor is going to come back with 40 things that are wrong with the boat, but there's usually only two or three that are of any real consequence. The rest is no double hose clamps on this, or, you know, little this, little that. And, you know, pick the big battles. Always pick the big